meeting. Thank you. Please be seated. Good afternoon, and I welcome everyone as we have come together in this place in the presence of God to join this man and woman in holy marriage. And today we're reminded that marriage is instituted by God. It is regulated by his commandments. It is blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and it is to be held in honor among all people. We therefore remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of the human family. And it is for this reason that our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, and to share in each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and in sorrow, to provide for each other and for their household, to pray for and encourage each other, and to live together as heirs of the grace of God. Because the two of you have come here today seeking God's blessing for your marriage, I charge you both in his presence, if either of you knows of any reason why you may not be joined together at this time, to please acknowledge so now. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, your presence is the joy of every occasion, and your favor hallows every relationship. Tonight we ask that you be especially present and gracious to these two persons, and we pray that they may be truly joined in one with your blessing. As you have brought them together in your providence, we ask that you sanctify them with your Holy Spirit, giving them a new mind and heart for their life together. And we ask that you grant to them now and always the promise of your guidance and support through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Octavio, I ask you, will you have this woman to be your wife? And will you give yourself to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, and to live with her and cherish her as long as you both shall live? Robin, will you take this man to be your husband? And will you give yourself to him in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, and to live with him and cherish him as long as you both shall live? I, Octavio.
I, Octavio.
Take you, Robin.
Take you, Robin.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I, Robin.
I, Robin.
Take you, Octavia.
To
be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And to have and to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer
or poorer.
In
sickness and in health.
In
to love and to cherish.
Until
then, do us.
Thank you.
You have your peace. give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
In token and in pledge.
In token and in pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
In token and in pledge.
In token and in pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Well, you've exchanged your vows and rings, expressing your desire to be united as one in the Christ honoring marriage. It was Jesus Christ who caused the light to shine out of the darkness at the beginning of creation, who also made the claim that I am the light of the world, and whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. You are also the light of the world, light of the world. And let your light so shine before men that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. As you enter marriage, may the light of his presence in your life and his works through you be seen as a light into the darkness. May that truth now be reflected as you take the flames from two separate candles and blend them into one. By the authority committed to me as a minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, I now declare that you are husband and wife, according to the ordinance of God and the laws of the state of Texas. I ask that the Lord bless you and keep you, and that the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you, and that the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and in the life everlasting. You may kiss your bride.
Long if I can.